The Battle of the Trench. Soon, the Jewish tribe of Bani Nadir, that were expelled from their homes because of what they had done to the Muslims, wanted to get back the land they'd lost and wanted to wipe out the Muslims. They started to recruit and negotiate alliances with other tribes, including the idol worshippers of Mecca. They also negotiated with the hypocrites of the Muslims to help them attack the Muslims. The enemies of Islam also went to the biggest Bedouin tribe in the area and bribed them with half of their produce in Kabar for 1 year as payment if they were to join them in battle, which they accepted. In the fifth year of the Muslims migrating to Medina, Abu Sufyan, the leader of the non-believers, set out with 10,000 men from different tribes. This was the greatest army ever seen in the Arabian Peninsula at the time. The Muslims only had about 2,500 to 3,000 men, so they were greatly outnumbered once again. This battle was called the Battle of Al-Azeb, which translates to the Battle of the Confederates or Groups, because different groups of enemies of Islam got together to attack the Muslims. This battle is also known as the Battle of the Trench. The Muslims needed a plan to defend themselves against the enemies of Islam. One of the companions, Salman the Persian, peace be upon him, suggested digging a deep ditch around the city, making it difficult for the enemies to cross over quickly. They did not need to dig through the entire city, since part of the city of Medina was covered in volcanic rock formations, mountains, houses tightly congested together, and large plantations of date trees, making it impossible for large armies to get through. Digging a trench was a technique used by the Persians, and it was unheard of to the Arabs. All the Muslims, including Prophet Muhammad and children, worked together to dig the trenches, using only a shovel each. The trench was about 13 feet wide and 2 kilometers long, and took somewhere around 1 to 2 weeks to dig. Once the trench had been dug, they waited for the enemies to come. When they arrived, the enemies of Islam saw the ditch and were surprised. The enemies of Islam realized they would not be able to jump past the ditch with their animals because of its width, and they would not be able to climb down the ditch with their animals either. They would have to go down the ditch individually, putting themselves at risk of easily getting hit by the Muslims as they climbed down. The enemies of Islam camped outside the trenches in their tents and discussed their next move. Then, the enemies decided to send someone to the Jewish tribe living inside Medina and ask them to join and help them attack the Muslims from inside. The Jewish tribe living inside initially refused at first because of their treaty with the Muslims. But after being tempted, they agreed to join the enemies and attack the Muslims from inside while the others attacked the Muslims from the outside. Once the Muslims heard the Jewish tribe from inside had betrayed the Muslims panicked and got terrified as they were about to be attacked from both the inside and outside of the city. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, sent all the women and kids to the house of one of the companions who was blind. Then God the Almighty sent down strong winds, a sandstorm, which has never hit the city of Medina like this before. The enemy's pots of food were blown and spilled all over, and it became very difficult to see anything. The enemies had no other choice but to flee, which they did, and they were defeated without a war. The Muslims then eliminated the Jewish tribe of Banu Qurayza that betrayed the Muslims living inside the city of Medina.